Are you serious? Are you serious? Wow! Russia is offering to mediate, broker a peace deal between the United States and North Korea over, of course, the missile program, the nuclear missile programs. Matter of fact, over at Bart Begley's website, the Crusader Journal, U.S. sanctions North Korea missile experts and Russia offers to mediate negotiations. The United States announced sanctions on two of North Korean's officials behind their country's ballistic missile program today, while Russia reiterated an offer to mediate to ease the tensions between Washington and Kim Jong-un in North Korea. Matter of fact, the new U.S. steps were the latest in a campaign aimed at forcing North Korea, which has defied years of multilateral and bilateral sanctions, to abandon a weapon program aimed at developing nuclear-tipped missiles capable of hitting the United States. The U.S. Treasury named the officials as Kim Jong-suk and Ri Pyong-chol. It is said that Kim was reportedly the key figure in North Korea's efforts to switch its missile program from liquid to solid fuel, while Ri Pyong-chol was reported to be the key official in its intercontinental ballistic missile, or ICBM, development. The Treasury is targeting leaders now of North Korea's ballistic missile programs as part of our maximum pressure campaign to isolate North Korea and achieve a fully denuclearized Korean peninsula, according to Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin. The largely symbolic steps block any property or interest the two might have within U.S. jurisdiction and prohibit any dealings by U.S. citizens with them. Now, of course, Russia has just made an offer. The Kremlin said today they've long called for the two sides to hold negotiations, said it was ready to act as a mediator if the United States and North Korea were willing for it to play such a role. Russia's readiness to clear the way for de-escalation is obvious, said Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov. He told reporters this in Moscow. When asked to comment on the offer, a spokesman for the United States Department, Justin Higgins, said the United States has the ability to communicate with North Korea through a variety of diplomatic channels. Quote, "We want the North Korean regime to understand that there's a different path that it can choose. However, it is up to North Korea to change course and return to a credible negotiations." Now, Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov, who made a similar offer yesterday, told the United States Secretary of State Rex Tillerson in a phone call today that Washington's aggressive rhetoric and beefing up of its military presence in the region had heightened the tensions and was unacceptable, according to the Russian Foreign Ministry. Also, Lavrov underscored the need for the fastest move to the negotiating process from the language of sanctions. Another State Department spokesman, Michael Carvey, said Washington remained open to talks, but the onus was on the North Koreans to take sincere and meaningful actions toward denuclearization and refrain from further provocations. He said that North Korea had made clear through its words and actions it is not interested in dialogue at this stage. Now, South Korea's unification ministry forecasted today that North Korea would look to open negotiations with the United States next year, 2018, while continuing, though, to seek recognition as a de facto nuclear power. Washington has stressed the need for all countries, especially Russia and China, North Korea's main trading partner, to fully implement the sanctions, including by cutting off oil supplies. According to Chinese customs data, China's exported no oil products to North Korea in November, apparently going above and beyond the UN sanctions imposed earlier this year. While Beijing also imported no North Korean iron ore, no coal, or lead in November, the second full month of those trade sanctions. Beijing has not disclosed its crude oil exports to North Korea for several years, but industry sources say that it's somewhere in the 520,000 tons or 3.8 million barrels a year to North Korea because of the aging pipeline. North Korea also sources some of its own oil from Russia. Now, trade between North Korea and China has slowed through the year, particularly after China was banned all the coal purchases in February, and Chinese exports of corn to North Korea in November also slumped, down 82% from a year earlier, and the lowest since January. So exports of rice is down 64% since the lowest that is since March. China has expressed concern about the humanitarian efforts of these sanctions and has repeatedly called for constructive efforts to ease the tensions. So Trump is putting pressure on China that they better stop their exporting. China is responding by not sending any iron ore, oil, or coal into North Korea and to cut down the corn, the rice, and other staples of even food products into North Korea. But will China hold that line? If so, how much longer? And can Trump force the North Koreans to the table by squeezing them in a blockade? Part of the reason China's exports into North Korea are so low is the United States is setting up a soft blockade. Okay? So we're going to keep a close eye on what's going on here. Very interesting that Russia wants to get involved and try to, you know, be the mediators, but I don't see this happening. Trump doesn't need Russia to mediate. Trump needs North Korea to cooperate. All right, we're going to keep a close eye on what's going on. Pope says the winds of war are blowing. Matter of fact, blamed it on Trump, said the Middle East and Asia were byproducts, basically, of Trump's aggression and animosity, if you will, creating tensions. His decision, he says, for Trump to name Jerusalem the capital of Israel has brought tension to the Middle East, he says, and his escalating rhetoric with Kim Jong-un has created tensions in South Asia. The truth is, Trump is just standing up against the bullies, doing what nobody's ever done before. But the Pope made a dangerous mistake. He prophesied that the winds of war were blowing. And he pointed those winds of war to Israel. He was as if he was saying, go get them to the Muslim nations. Very careful. The Pope better be very, very careful. He used his Christmas Day message to prophesy World War III. Well, we're going to wait and see. I'll be back with more current world events and how they relate to biblical prophecy. Should be a very interesting evening tonight. I'll be live at 10 p.m. Eastern. That's 10 p.m. Eastern on prime time. Live. I'll see you guys tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern. Are you serious?